Assalamu alaikum, grade 1, and welcome to your social studies class. And I'm your ma'am Umama. In today's class, we will be revising the topic that we did in this week, and the topic was my family, right? Okay, so we started from the very basic things. We started from the general introduction that why we are starting this topic, why there is need to talk about the family. And then I told you that in this society which we live, there are a lot of relationships that we have, right? And so among those relationships, among all of those relations, the very important thing is our family, right? Okay. And why is family so important? Because we live with our family, we have a small strong bonding with our family, we are very much dependent on each and everything. There are relationships within the family, or the connections within the family through which we live and go through our life, right? So then we talked about we made a mind map, and we discussed all of the related terms related to the family, and then we talked about how we can introduce our family to somebody. Then I show you the different introductions. We talked about the introduction that was in your book, which was Hassan's introduction about his family. And then we also discussed, we watched a video about Sajawal. Sajawal made a family tree, right? So similarly, in today's class, you will also be making a family tree in which you will be writing how many family members are there. Then you will tell their names as well, because it's important to tell their names as well, right? Then you will talk about some of the family things that you do together. Okay, so I'll be making a family tree in front of you, and then you will be making the same on your notebooks. Okay, so we also talked about that what are the important things that we should mention or that we should discuss when somebody asks us to define our family. So I told you that first of all, the family members, that how many family members do you have, is very important information that you are supposed to tell somebody, right? Then telling their names. And I told you that there are multiple types of families. We also discussed that, right? So you can also mention that as well. If your family lies in that category, let's say you have a small family with a single child, so you can say that I belong to a single child family, right? You can start your introduction with this, so the reader or the other person can easily get an idea. Okay, this is a very small family. Similarly, you can say that I belong to a large family, so the people may get, or the other person may get an idea that you must have 2 to 3 siblings, or maybe your grandparents will be living with you, right? So all of these points were important for that, right? So now I'll be making a family tree for you, and then you will be making the same on your notebooks. Okay, so first of all, I'm sharing the screen with you. There is a small, very cute family tree through which you can get an idea. Okay, is my screen visible? Okay, perfect. So there is this a picture of a family tree. If you look at this, it started from on the very top bottom of the tree. The person, whoever, let's say the girl was introducing her family. So she said, me and my brother. So on the bottom, similarly, you can also make a tree, and on the bottom you can talk about yourself and your siblings. Let's say you also have a one sibling, you can draw his picture, and if you have 2, 3, you can make the bottom a little bigger, and then you can add the other as well. Then above that, you will be talking about your parents, right? Your mother and your father. And if you belong to a different type of family in which there's a stepmom or a stepfather or anyone, right? You can mention that as well. Then on above that, you will be talking about your grandparents. First, you will talk about the grandparents from your mother's side, and then your grandparents from your father's side. And let's say you have somebody else who is living with you. Let's say your cousins are living with you. You live with your uncle as well, and your uncle, aunt, and cousins also live. So you can, above that, you can talk about your uncle, aunt, and then their siblings. Got it? Very well done. Okay. So you may get an idea through that how you can make a family tree. It's not compulsory that you adopted the same method. You can use your own. You can choose some good way for that, and color it with, multiple colors and make it cute. Can you see the faces? All of them have very cute smiling faces. And for grandparents, the person has drawn, beautiful glasses and the white hair, which shows that the person are older, right? Okay, so Now, stop sharing the screen. I will be drawing a family tree for you, and you will be drawing for yourself, okay? Now, look at my family tree. Because I don't have more space, right? So my tree does not look more cute. Or what we can do is we can erase social studies from here so that I get good space for that, okay? Okay. So the method I'll be adopting will be the same that the person adopted. Okay. So I'll be writing it me over here. And I have three more siblings, so let's draw it in this way, me, and then my three siblings. Okay, then there will be a connection, and then my parents. Okay, let's write parents over here, and let's write siblings over here. Okay, then we will move forward, and there will be my grandparents, 2 and 2, right? So these are grandparents. Now, the thing that I told you, that if somebody else is living with you, let's say your uncle, aunt, what you can do on your notebook, you will be having a lot of space. So you can draw some more boxes over here above that, and then you can write your uncle and aunt, then your, then their siblings or their kids, right? Sorry. So their kids as well, right? Then write their names. Now, let's say in this, I can write my own name, which is Amama. Then I can use my sibling names, Zakria, Abdullah and Ahmad. Okay, then over here I can write my parents' name. Let's say Mr. Mubarak Deen. And my mother name. Then over here you will be writing your grandparents. Or the good idea that you can do is, let's say because you have a long weekend, what you can do, you can take out the pictures of your parents, your grandparents and siblings, make a family tree, a cute family tree, and then paste their pictures in it. Okay, this would be a small assignment for you, that over the weekend you are supposed to take out the prints of their pictures and then paste them in these boxes, make a wonderful family tree, do color it, and do made it by yourself. Do not ask somebody at your home to made it for you. Okay, made it, color it, and then paste the pictures in it, and it will look wonderful. Okay, so this is your assignment. Draw the tree now in the class and then paste the pictures at your home, because you might not be having all of the pictures right now. Okay, so, and let me know when you are done. Okay, class, so all of you are done. That was all for today. What we discussed, we ended the topic, which was my family. And today we did a small activity that was creating a family tree. I show you, I give you the idea, but you can make a different from that as well. Maybe you started from the top, you write the sibling names on the top, and then you come on the bottom. And maybe you started from the bottom and moved toward the top. It's all up to you, whatever the way you choose for, okay? So, and I gave you an assignment as well, that you are supposed to make a family tree and paste the pictures in the blanks or in the areas where you are supposed to write the names of the people, okay? And then on the top, do mention how many family members there are in total, okay? Or you can write on the on one side, on left hand side, on right hand side, all of the family members' name, okay? So do revise all of this, whatever we have covered in this week, and prepare yourself for the assessment that we will be taking in tomorrow's class, inshallah. And I'll be seeing you in the next class. Until then, take care and Allah Hafiz. And don't forget to share this video with others, okay? Because do good and have good. Excellent. Allah Hafiz.